Hello everyone and welcome back to Football Manager 2024 and another experiment today where we're taking a look at what would happen if you tried to destroy a Premier League team in the game. And the team, of course, that we're going to use is Manchester City. They are the most reputable and probably powerful team in the game. So if you want a challenge, destroying this club is probably the best way to go about it. Now, I've got quite a simple approach to how I'm going to try and do this, and that is to hit them financially. Everything I can do to damage their finances is going to be put in place. So starting off with their reputation, that's been dropped from about 9,000 to just 1. Morale has been dropped to 1, club attendance dropped to 1, minimum club attendance 1, maximum club attendance all set to 1. So it's one man turning up to watch the three-time Premier League most recent champions. We've also made them an amateur club, given them £650 million of debt, given them £300 million negative transfer budget, and also destroyed the wage budget. So there's no way they can meet their requirements around that. And also their sugar daddy is also gone. I've totally destroyed their income sources. There's no commercial income available to the club. And I've given them over £1 billion in debt, £400 million of which they need to pay back by the 28th, by 2028. And also they have £15 million in monthly repayments and then another £4 million there. So just try and get those monthly payments racked up. And then finally, I've taken the Julian Alvarez transfer and I've made it so that they have to pay £20 million per month to River Plate over the next 100 months. So that is £144 million every year that they need to pay River Plate for that transfer. And that will be going on for about 7-8 years. So lots of money leaving the club. And then if they start to do really well and improve, I'm going to do the same thing again. I'm hoping not to have to do that many times. I think I'll maybe do it once a few years into the game, because the longer it goes on, the more destroyed they're going to be. And then to keep it simple, what we're going to do is jump forward 100 years into the future, or thereabouts, maybe 80 years into the future, to the year 2100 or so, and have a look at if they have finally stopped being a, or if they've become a non-league team. We don't want them playing in the Football League in England anymore. That's the objective. So what we're going to do now is just jump forward 80 years into the future and see how they're getting on. Well, we have gone 100 years in the future, and you can see the very first season that these sanctions were in place, City did finish in second in the Premier League, but the descent was pretty quick after that as they went to fifth, then they fell to 13th, and then they've got relegated in bottom place in the league with just 16 points, only 4 years after this experiment started. In the Championship, things did not get too much better for them. If we go all the way back to the start of this game, we've gone quite a bit further on and have a look at their first season in the Championship, then we can see that they got relegated in 23rd position immediately. So once more, we need to drop back down and have a look at the league table for League One. Back-to-back relegations for Man City, seeing them fall really fast into League One. Their first season in League One, that was a year after this, we can see Man City, they did get promoted, finishing in third, but it was very quick return back down. I think just a couple of years later, you can see Man City did get relegated into League Two and suffered a 12-point points deduction, which knocked them out of potentially the playoff positions down to 15th. The year after that, relegated in 24th position to League Two. So that must have been around the year 2031. If we take another quick look at the league table and just wait for that Man City name to drop into this league. Took a bit longer than I expected, actually, for them to drop into League Two. But you can see them here, 12-point deduction again as they kept falling into administration. Another 12-point deduction. And the year after that, another 12-point deduction. So they're going into administration every single season. And the next year, the same thing happens as they finish in 20th place. And then finally, the deduction really takes its toll. And in the year 2039, they fall into League Two. I think they do come back and then get relegated in bottom place again. And there's a little bit of jumping up and down that takes place in the leagues. But they have, at this point, basically ceased to be
to be a league football team. Now, if we go back and just have a look at Man City and their transfers, then you can see in the first season, it was all money out. They're obviously under embargo all the time. The big players leaving, going Bernardo Silva going to Al Hilal, Erling Haaland going to PSG, and then lots of other players following them out the door. Ruben Diaz going, and then on free transfer, even Kevin De Bruyne leaving the club. And by this point, they'd basically lost everyone. Gvardiol, Kovacic, Husai, who they'd signed the year before, also leaving. And then the year after that, they're in the Championship. Mateus Nunez leaves, and by the time they're in League One, there is very few players left. James McAtee, Perone, I don't think there's anyone left. Thiago Tomas, maybe. But they're basically down in League One at this point, League Two. And you can see they do get a tycoon come in around this time, which is why the amount of money they're spending suddenly shoots up. And at that point, I step in and decide to put another huge sanction on them. So you can see £62 million then suddenly goes out and they have to start balancing the books. And at this point, their money does become a little bit more, as you might expect, in the 30, 40, 50k mark as they are finally relegated into non-league football. So overall, I mean, they're in a fantastic stadium. Despite destroying their stadium, they moved to a new one called the David Silva Arena with 81,000 fans there. They've still got 22,000 season ticket holders, which, if we have a look, 3,000 reputation, 7 morale, 110 club attendance, 25,000 maximum attendance, and yet they have 22,000 season ticket holders. So they're clearly just not showing up to the matches. Their reputation's fallen through the floor. They're semi-professional. They've got $12 million in the bank. Very little income. No debt, though, which is nice. No transfer clauses. And their facilities are not horrendous, but they have managed to recover most of the other things. But generally speaking, they've got the perfect shell for a non-league team, but they're still suffering from their financial consequences and are not quite able to make it back up to the top of the game. And in their recent history, if we have a look, you can see they were in non-league football, made it back into League Two a couple of times in the early, late 80s, early 90s. But since then, Valarama National League are now in the National League North and struggling to get back into the National League. So they have not been able to really kick on and get out. Their owner is looking to leave right now, which is not a shock. If we have a look at their landmarks here, you can see they moved to a temporary stadium before going back to the Etihad. Then I came in and destroyed the club again, and they had to leave. And then eventually a tycoon took over. I'm just telling you, like, when did they move to the David Silva Stadium? That came later. So they had the tycoon here, and then I came in and destroyed them again as they failed financial fair play in League One. New owners coming in. At some point, they built the David Silva Stadium. Oh, there it is, 2032. So this is after the tycoon came in and paid for the new stadium to be built. But loads and loads of takeovers taking place, going into administration year after year. You can see coming out of administration, new owners. It's basically like going to administration, get a new owner every single year. And eventually, they do start to stabilize a little bit. They get a new chairman in the 50s. And then in the 60s, but they stop going into administration as they basically settle for occasionally winning the Vanarama National League and getting out. But they do get relegated from League Two again and then don't come back. They do finish as National League North champions in 21-02, but they've not done it since. And they are slowly trying to rebuild their club out of nothing. But despite this huge stadium, they don't seem to be able to generate the income they need to escape the situation they find themselves in. And I would say that we have successfully destroyed this club. So if you did enjoy this little experiment, do drop a like down below. Let me know in the comments if you have ideas for other experiments, and make sure to hit that subscribe button if you're new. But until next time, see ya.